In this example, we're going to work with a vector space, and we're actually going to find a basis for the vector space. So that means any element from the vector space I can write as a linear combination of the basis vectors. So the set of vectors we're going to work with is this set of vectors, the vectors 1, 0, 1, minus 2, 1, 4, and 0, 3, 1. So we have three vectors of length 3. And we are asked, is this set of vectors a basis for R3? So R3 is the collection of all vectors of length 3. If this set is a basis for R3, then any vector from R3 can be written as a linear combination of these three things. So in this case, we're not really coming up with a basis. We're actually asked, is this provided collection of vectors a basis for R3? So how can we figure that out? Well, since we're working with R3, we know that we need three linearly independent vectors, because that's just the rule that we have for vector spaces. If you have three dimensions, you need three linearly independent vectors to form a basis. So really the question becomes, given that I've been provided these three vectors, are they linearly independent? Are these three things linearly independent? So what I need to do is I need to check for linear independence of the three vectors. And there's a few different ways that we can do that. Let's go ahead and do it the first way, and we'll also do it, part B, we'll do it using determinants. But in this first way, what we'll actually do is we will write down a matrix corresponding to the three vectors, and we'll do some row operations to reduce it. So the first row operation I'll do is E3, replace E3 with E3 minus E1. So rows 2 and 1 don't change, but row 3 looks like this. Then I can replace row 3 with row 3 minus 6E2 to get rid of the 6 there. So I'll have a 0, a 0, and a 1. I can go ahead and replace E2 with E2 minus 3E3. So rows 1 and 3 don't change, but row 2 will turn into 0, 1, 0. And then I can replace row 1 with row 1 plus 2e2. So rows 2 and 3 don't change. But row 1, or equation 1, will be 1, 0, 0. So I've performed row operations, and I was able to turn my starting matrix, whose each column corresponds to a vector in our basis, I've been able to transform it into a identity matrix. So if I look at this, what do I see? I see three pivots. Here's 1, here's 2, and here's 3. So those three pivots tell me something pretty important. It tells me that I have three linearly independent vectors. So it turns out that these vectors are linearly independent. If I had had only two pivots, then I would know that just two of them were linearly independent. But since I had three, I have three linearly independent vectors, and this does form a basis for R3. Another way to work this problem is to use determinants. So let's think about that. We know how to use determinants to check for linear independence. So one way to do this would be just to compute the determinant of the matrix that we form. If you actually take that matrix that we started with, a 3x3, and compute its determinant, you get the number minus 17. We're not going to go through all the computations by hand to do this. I have other videos that do that. But computing that determinant gives us the number minus 17, which is not equal to 0, and that's the important part. If it was equal to 0, 0 would imply that they are linearly dependent. Since the determinant is not equal to 0, that means that they are linearly independent. So computing the determinant tells us that we have three linearly independent columns, which means we have three linearly independent vectors, which means we have enough vectors to form a basis for R3. So this is another way that you could check that the given vectors do indeed form a basis for R3. Obviously, if you are working with some other vector space, you know, R2 or R4 or R7, you would need to be given two vectors or four vectors or seven vectors to figure out if the collection of vectors was linearly independent. And you could use either the determinant method or the kind of reduced row approach to check the number of pivots. Either of those methods would be a legit way to check for, is the given set of vectors a basis for the vector space?